So let's take a look at the new features of iOS 12. I think the most powerful new feature by far is the ability to customize Siri. These are called Siri Shortcuts, and there are two ways to add them. One is to go into Settings, go into Siri and Search, and here you can add shortcuts. Now there's some suggestions that appear right there for things that you've done, websites you've gone to, phone numbers you've called, things like that. So you could go ahead and select one of those, just hit the plus button there. Say if I wanted to go to this website here, I could customize it by pressing the red button here, make me laugh, and now I could say done, and now that's added there so that I could just say, you know, ask Siri to make me laugh and it's going to go to the website. Now much more powerful than that is the ability to use the Shortcuts app and build your own shortcuts. So this is similar to the Workflow app that existed before as a standalone third-party app. You could go ahead and add a new shortcut and you can drag actions, and there are tons of different actions you can drag and you can put them together. It's like Automator on the Mac. Matter of fact, not only can you have different commands that control different apps, but you can do scripting things like asking for input, getting clipboard, you know, doing loops, storing variables, all sorts of things. And you can construct your own scripts in Shortcuts and then assign a Siri command to those. Now if you use an emoji and you need one of the newer iPhones or last year's iPhone 10, you can get 4 new an emoji now to the list. But more importantly than that, you can get your own. So you can create a Memoji. And there's a whole little builder here for creating your own character and customizing the character. So you can have a lot of fun with that and then use these characters in your messages, but you can also use them in FaceTime. So here I am talking to myself in FaceTime, and I can tap this button here and I can select an emoji or Memoji and actually use that instead of myself. And you can see it still includes the background. You can see my hand there. It just replaces my head with it. But you can also do more than just that. You can use all these different effects here. Like there's filters that you could use. There are all sorts of other little things that you can do. You can draw, for instance, put shapes. So you have lots of effects that you can use in FaceTime now. There are also improvements to notifications. There's a bunch of different improvements and settings you can change. One of the main ones is grouping. You can see here I've got a group of 20 notifications all from the same source there. So instead of just filling up my screen with notifications, I've got that. Also, wherever you see notifications, you can go in now and you can manage the notifications. So you can set it on to deliver quietly or turn off notifications or go to settings. So you don't have to go and find that notification source in settings now to change it. You could just do it right there when you see a notification. There's a small but significant improvement to how Do Not Disturb works. When you turn it on from Control Center, you can of course just turn it on, but you can also tap and hold, and now you can actually turn it on for an hour or until this evening, not until tomorrow morning, or until I leave this location. So now when you have a meeting, you want to turn on Do Not Disturb, you can say until I leave this location, and now you don't have to remember to turn it off. Another big new feature is screen time. You can find this in the Settings app. You can go into it and it gives you a complete rundown of how you're using your phone or iPad. You can go in and see all the different categories. You can dig down by category, by app. You can set a passcode so somebody can't make these changes. And you can actually do limits on different apps and different categories of apps. You can either impose that on yourself or you can kind of set it up as parental restrictions for maybe an iPad that you're going to give to a child. There are a lot of other changes as well. There are some major redesigns to apps. For instance, the Stocks app now has a big new redesign. It's got news in it. The News app itself has some new things. There's a redesigned Voice Memos app. The iBooks app is now Books, and it's got a slight redesign to it as well. There's security stuff. Safari is better at preventing websites from tracking you. There's also security code autofill, which is a neat feature. When you get one of those texts, you know, for a security code to fill in for an app or website, that text will automatically become part of autofill on the keyboard. So it makes it easier instead of having to copy and paste to remember that code. If you use CarPlay, Now Google Maps and Waze are both going to be available as apps in CarPlay. It's nice of Apple to make third party maps available there as well as their own. There's some new AR stuff. There's a new measurement app that you can measure things in a room. There's also the ability for developers to create AR apps where you're actually like playing a game or experiencing something with another person. So you're both seeing a shared augmented reality, like a pool table in the middle of the room, and you could both see it through your device. There's a whole bunch of other things too. There's an English thesaurus that you'll be able to access in addition to the dictionary that's already built in. And the battery info in settings now has some more detail to it, which is really nice as well. So there's a lot of cool new things in iOS 12. One notable missing thing that was hyped was the group FaceTime, the ability to FaceTime with lots of other people. But that's not actually going to be in the initial release, but Apple has promised that it will come out as part of iOS 12 at some point in the future. So look for that in coming months.